Namaskar. In this session, we will cover up the issue of manufacturing of casein and what is casein. If we see, casein is the principal protein in milk, whether it is edible casein or industrial casein, they have wide application in the industry. Edible casein is used as an ingredient in many dairy and food products. The manufacture of edible casein differs from the non-edible casein or industrial casein is that it is produced under sanitary conditions. Further, during its manufacture, food grade chemicals are to be used and sufficiently heat treatment is given to the milk to make it safe for human consumption. In milk industry, when the milk is subjected to the process of cream separation, a huge quantity of skim milk is generated. Skim milk can be utilized for, apart from other applications, skim milk can be gainfully utilized for manufacturing of casein, which is the principal protein in the milk. About 80% of milk protein is constituted by casein, while another approximately 20% is constituted by whey proteins. Casein, there are various methods to classify the casein. One is by the, depending upon the use of coagulating agent used, by sulfuric acid or by hydrochloric acid, that is acid casein manufactured by direct acidification with mineral acid such as HCl and H2SO4, lactic casein which is produced by growth of lactic starter culture. Another type of casein is the rennet casein. It is also the edible casein and it is produced by using rennet as the coagulating agent. According to Food Standard and Safety Authority of India standards, which is erstwhile PFA, edible casein products mean the products obtained by washing and drying the coagulum of skimmed milk. The skim milk is precipitated using rennet or lactic culture and the curd is separated from the whey. Then edible non-animal rennet casein means the product obtained after washing and drying the coagulum remaining after separating whey from skim milk which has been coagulated by non-animal rennet or by other enzyme. In case of edible non-rennet casein, the coagulating medium may be lactic cultures of bacteria. FSSAI has laid down the standards for moisture, milk fat, milk proteins, casein in the protein, ash and lactose present. So, two type of casein, one is non-animal rennet casein. Non-animal rennet, in this case the casein may be precipitated by hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid or by any lactic culture. And in acid casein, the casein may be precipitated by hydrochloric acid and sulfuric acid, but not by rennet. So, the moisture, it will not be more than 12% non-animal rennet casein, and in acid casein also the moisture shall not be more than 12%. The milk fat shall not be more than 2%. In acid casein also the fat level shall not be above 2%. The milk protein, it shall not be less than 84%. Casein is nothing but milk protein only. So, milk protein content should not be less than 84% in non-animal rennet casein, while in case of acid casein, it should be not less than 95%, milk protein 90%. Casein in the protein, it should not be less than 95% in both the cases. Ash, it shall not be less than 7.5%. While in case of acid casein, it shall not be less than 2.5%. There should be practically no lactose in the dried casein. So, lactose, which is the milk sugar, it should not be more than 1% in case of non-animal rennet casein, and it should not be more than 1% in case of acid casein, which is prepared by coagulating skim milk with hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, or by lactic culture. Earlier I had told that non-animal rennet casein is the product where non-animal rennet is used, baclogical rennet that can be used for precipitation of casein from the skim milk. Now, once we see the uses of casein, casein is widely used in manufacture of in paper industry for manufacturing paper coatings. Then casein is also utilized in manufacturing water resistant glues. Casein is also used in the manufacture of plastic and plastic materials. Casein is utilized in manufacturing of cold water paints and preparation of fiber and food binders. Casein has a wide application for industrial processes. Apart from that, casein is utilized in manufacturing of many dairy products such as calcium caseinate, etc. I have told you that one is acid casein and other is the acid casein or industrial casein, and then is rennet casein. So, here we will see how acid casein is manufactured. The base material for manufacturing of casein should be the fresh skim milk. However, the sour skim milk also, the milk which curdles during transportation from the village level cooperative societies to the milk plant becomes sour, and that the skim milk so generated out of separating that sour milk is called as sour skim milk, and that can be effectively utilized for manufacturing of casein. But preferably for good quality casein, we should use the fresh skim milk whose acidity should not be 0.1 to 0.12% of lactic acid. For preparing of acid casein, we have to first prepare the coagulating solution. So, if we are using hydrochloric acid, in that case, one part of hydrochloric acid should be diluted with 5 to 9 parts of water. And in case we are using sulfuric acid or H2SO4 as the coagulating solution for skim milk, in that case, one part of sulfuric acid should be diluted with 6 to 30 parts water all by weight. Normally, in case of hydrochloric, one part of acid is diluted with 6 parts of water, and in case of sulfuric acid, one part is diluted with approximately 20 parts of water for preparing the coagulating solution for coagulating the skim milk. At next stage, we take the available fresh, clean, sweet skim milk. In case we have the sour skim milk, that also can be utilized for manufacturing of casein, but it is preferred that the skim milk should be fresh, clean, sweet, and it should be free from any off odor. At next stage, we heat the skim milk to approximately 35 degree centigrade for precipitating with hydrochloric acid, and heat it to 37 degree centigrade once we are using H2SO4 as the precipitating agent. Then next step, add diluted and cooled acid to the preheated milk, slowly stirring gently all the time till the pH reaches up to 4.1, when the curd precipitates completely and whey is clear. At pH 4.1, all the casein which is present in milk is separated out and clear whey is generated. You allow at that temperature, you allow the coagulum to remain as such for few minutes. During this period, the curd will settle completely and drain the whey using a cloth strainer. Next, wash the curd slightly with acidulated water at least twice so that all the whey which is sticking to the curd is washed away, removed, and quantity of water should be equal to the quantity of whey which has been drained off, and the temperature of water utilized for washing the excess acid from the coagulating mass should be around 32 degrees centigrade. At the end, you give last washing with cold neutral water. Once the casein curd is washed, drain wash water completely and keep the washed curd in casein press for 1 to 2 hours to drain off the excess moisture and to get a dried curd. Then dried curd you take out of the press and press it in a curd mill. Then milled curd may be spread on the drying trays of casein dryer. It may be a batch dryer or continuous dryer and with an air temperature of 70 to 75 degrees centigrade and outlet air temperature of 50 to 55 degrees centigrade. This curd in the casein dryer is spread in the drying trays and it is slightly agitated from time to time so that moisture is evenly removed. I was talking about the milling. The pressed curd is milled into pieces and then it is spread on the drying trays of the casein dryer. Once the dried casein is obtained, in that case shift casein to casein grinder and ground casein can be collected in Hessian laminated craft paper bags or lined with a polythene liner for storage and further disposal. So, this was about manufacturing of acid casein from the fresh sweet skim milk utilizing hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid or the lactic culture. In case of rennet casein, you take fresh sweet skim milk and heat to 38 degrees centigrade. This should be followed by addition of 70 to 100 ml of rennet extract. Rennet extract contains rennin enzyme which coagulates the skim milk, and rennet extract should be diluted. Dried rennet powder extract should be diluted with 20 times its volume with the fresh and clean water. Add the rennet solution and leave the milk undisturbed for 20 to 30 minutes. During 20 to 30 minutes, the coagulation will be completed. The coagulated mass, once the coagulation is completed, after 2 to 5 minutes, cut the curd using the curd knives and simultaneously heat the curd in with coagulum with whey up to a temperature of 50 degrees centigrade. This is done for recovering maximum amount of casein from the coagulated mass. After this, allow the curd to settle for few minutes and drain the whey. After draining of the whey, wash with water at 30 degrees centigrade twice, and total quantity of water utilized for washing the cut curd shall be equal to the quantity of whey generated. After this, you press the curd in press for 1 to 2 hours. Then for rest the manufacturing process will remain the same. That means the milled curd will be spread on the tray dryer, little agitation and temperature outlet air roughly 50 degrees centigrade and inlet 70 to 75 degrees centigrade. Then it will be passed, then dried casein will be passed and it will be grinding will be done and ground material will be packed in Hessian bags or lined with the polythene liner. Thank you.